What does a holistic approach to medical school admissions mean at BU?
Yeah, so this is a great question because everybody says that they do holistic review.
That's right.
and then you're like, what does that really mean? I think it's kind of silly that medical schools don't just tell the process. So this is what we do. First of all, a human reads every single application. Last year, we had 10,600 and some applications, and a human reads every single one. And I'm not even kidding. It's really true. So the applications are reviewed, and we use a structured rubric to make sure that each application is evaluated, that we're looking for the same things in each application. And those things include things like research experience, clinical experience, your distance traveled, your mission fit, how well you fit with our mission. So we look at a bunch of different things. Each application, so there's a special team of reviewers that does the initial reviews. All these people are part of the admissions committee. It's about 12 or 13 people. So we all use this structured rubric. We read the applications. We evaluate them with each of those different metrics. And then we give a score to each of those different metrics. And then we tell the reviewers, do a big bunch of reviews, like 20 or 50. And then at the end of that 20 or 50, go back and your top 20%, you should designate those for interview. The next 20% we hang on to in case we have more time for, you know, time for more interviews, because we never know actually how many people we're going to get. And then the bottom 60%, we say, sorry, it doesn't really look like you're going to be competitive in our pool. Then you get invited for an interview, and a different person who is not the person that reviewed your application will be your interviewer. That person reviews the application with a slightly different focus. And so
that interviewer is also a member of the admissions committee.
Also a member of the admissions committee, also a faculty member, and they review the whole entire application. We don't blind it. Some people feel as though holistic review is better accomplished if you blind the interviewers or certain committee members to certain aspects of the application. I actually think that makes it not holistic, because then you are no longer looking at the whole entire application. To me, you're trying to figure out, you know, what you're trying to figure out when you're looking at academic metrics is how well prepared is this person to do well in medical school? And so to do that, you need to understand the whole entire application. Anyway, so the interviewer then reviews the whole application, conducts the interview, which is a semi-structured, very conversational interview, takes about 45 minutes, and then they write up a report. The interview report gets appended to the application. And then we have two selection meetings, one in November and one in February. And the selection meetings, the whole committee comes together. We break up into teams of four or five. Each team gets a stack of applications. Again, these are not applications that you reviewed or interviewed. And then they go and they discuss each one of the applications and make a recommendation about whether to accept, reject, or waitlist. So that's how we do our process. And I guess a couple of points to highlight there is that, again, I said a human reads every application, but actually, like, by the time you get to the stage of having a decision made, you've often had like 4 or 5 person hours of attention on your application between all these different people. Bringing a lot of people into the decision-making process and the analysis really helps to kind of mitigate bias.